I really do. Couple more things. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, one more time.
Thank you. seen Pastor, but I forgot.
The air feels good.
Thank you.
never ever doubt you. Thank you,
praise the Lord for that. But the next three countries that we are distributing in a French-speaking country, the Democratic Republic of Congo, had preached in the capital city of Kinshasa a few years ago. And then after the Congo, we got a distribution in France. And then Gabon, which is a French-speaking country in Africa. And I don't know about you, but I am so excited that we're now introducing a brand new language, but also, there is it, we're also on the Vietnamese edition and the Hmong language edition. And very soon, we're going to be having our outreach in Vietnam. But for several years, unfortunately, we imported guns, bullets, bombs, military. But now, we're going to be importing the Word of God. That's it. That's the Vietnamese right there. I'm sure you all can read that.
Yeah, if you know the chapter, yeah.
It says what it says. And but we're excited about this. And you know, what's amazing, of course, Vietnam is communist, but we have government approval. Not only for printing, but distribution in that country. And we want to thank Brother Dave Reaper, who was the one that was instrumental. You get Brother Dave?
Yeah.
He was the one that was instrumental in getting us to translate the Expositor Study Bible. And there's a great move of God going on in Vietnam, and especially among the Hmong people. That's another addition that we're putting out. They're the mountain people spread out over Vietnam, Cambodia, and Laos. And they are a repressed people. They don't have a lot of rights under the Vietnamese government. They're looked at as stepchildren. But they fought during the Vietnam War. They were very strong allies to America. And they were commandos. They were trained guerrilla fighters. But they're in the mountains, and a move of God is broken out, and they're getting saved. And when he came to us, he said, we've got to meet this need. He said, in, and they'll be coming in after church. And so we want to thank the Lord for that. But this is going to be a great youth camp. And then June 10th through the 14th, Dr. Dave Watts will be bringing us our next JSBC Summer Intensive class on how to study the Bible. And then July 8th through 12th, Dr. Jimmy Dupree will be teaching Intro to Christian Ministry. And all of you pastors and workers and associates, you need to avail yourself of these classes. For more information, you can go to jsbc.edu. Tonight at 6 o'clock, Dr. Dave Watts will be ministering for us. We always enjoy Dr. Watts when he's able to be with us. We let Texans on the platform every once in a while. And Danny is as Texan as you can get. Oh, by the way, that's not a demonic sign. You never knew that. I was preaching in this scripture years ago when Bush, the second Bush, was president. And this lady comes up to me. She's got this packet of papers. She said, I got to talk to her. She said, this is so horrible. I said, what is this wrong? It's horrible that you have a president that is openly and actively engaged in witchcraft. I said, what are you talking about? And then she opened this folder. She started pulling all these pictures of President Bush at UT events, football games, basketball, doing the hook and horn sign. And I had to burst her bubble and say, no, that's not a satanic sign, that's the universe.
Yeah, I remember that some years back. She I was doing just smooth with it.
She thought she had uncovered the Illuminati. Seances going on all the hours of the night. Children being offered up in sacrifice in the
roadside. They do it, but not us. It's foolish.
Dr. Watts will be ministering that Wednesday night, beginning this Wednesday night. Dave is going to be beginning a series, continuing with the series entitled The Miracles of Christ. And you're going to want to be here for that. And those of you watching, if you have a need, you need to get those prayer requests, because we'll be praying for your needs of these services. This morning, from 20 states and 5 countries, we want to welcome 44 brand new media church members from Alabama, Dennis, Bay, Arizona, Nancy, Arkansas, Danita, Florida, Gary, Janet, Wards, and Tamika, Illinois, Lona, Mary, Indiana, Betty, Eric, Maryland, Marie, Russell, Minnesota, Linda, Paul, Sandra, Mississippi, Joy, Missouri, Dolores,
Nebraska,
West, New York, Paula, North Carolina, Mark, Richard, Ohio, Randy, Teresa, Tennessee, Christine, John, Texas, Janelle, Tim, Virginia, Delbert, Kim, Lois, Valerie, Washington, Frank, Jill, Virginia, West Virginia, Sherman, Wisconsin, Lincoln, Australia, Clarissa, Shannon, from Chile, Luz, Kenya, Ishmael, Uganda, Julius, and the United Kingdom. Eric, family worship center, would you stand and look over to this camera on my left, and let's welcome all of our brand new family worship center media church members. Family worship center resurrection choir
and singers.
The boys do it.
Thank you.
Oh Lord, I'm thinking passion tomorrow morning. Well, thank God for whoever come on. Well, I think of that this morning. Good morning, good morning. It would be surprising.
was a choice.
Lord, thank you. I see you right.
She's life and not death.
Sing that little chorus. There's a you're able to join us on Wednesday night, we're going to be continuing our series on the miracles of Christ, and we're going to be looking at Mark chapter 4, when Jesus stills the storm. You see, every single one of us will face a storm in life, not once, not twice, but multiple storms. And it's critical for every single child of God to exhibit faith when we face life's storms.
Lord, thank you.
But many of us are fearful. But the same one that said, "Peace be still," 2,000 years ago, is the same one saying, "Peace be still," right now in 2024. So if you're facing a storm in your life, I want to encourage you. Be here Wednesday night. As Dad said, in the next several weeks, after every single service, we're going to be praying for everyone and praying for your needs. Because we believe that God's wanting to do something in this house on these Wednesday nights. And so be here if you can. Grace.
Thank you. Thank you.
take up our time, thank you all for your family and worship center today, and thank all of the community for support. As the ushers are coming, we're going to go into the Lord in prayer. We're going to believe God that He's going to bless every single person gives in this work. For those of you that are watching and listening, you can call the number on the screen, you can go online right now. Heavenly Father, we come before you in the name of Jesus. We thank you for all that you've done for us. We ask that you continue to watch over us and protect us. Bless us today as we give. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. March around this morning, please.
Talked about it.
And the purpose, well, let me say this first. There's going to be two great judgments that everyone who has ever lived will have to stand before the Lord. The first for the child of God, which will take place at the conclusion of the rapture, when the rapture is over, is called the judgment seat of Christ. And every single believer that has ever lived from the beginning of time until that moment will stand before the Lord. Now, we will not be judged for our salvation. That was taken care of at Calvary, and our faith in that finished work and what Jesus did secures our salvation. So what will we be judged? We will be judged by what we did with our salvation. I want that to sink in. We're going to have to give an account to the Lord as to what we did with this glorious experience that we call salvation. Now, I can go into so many times people are like, well, you know, to be faithful, you gotta do this. I mean, all of these things, the doing of things are all a part of it. But really what you're gonna get judged on is if you were faithful. That's it right there. That one word
to me, Lord Jesus, thank
you. It's not so much in how many services you went to, how much money that you dropped in the offering plate, and all of these things. Because all of those things, yes, they are good, and we should be doing them. If your faith is right, and you are faithful to the Lord, all of these other things will fall into the place, and they will be done accordingly. So it's not us worrying about, well, I've got to go, yeah, I missed one service this month, so I've got to make it up. Now, you should never miss a church service. I mean, if the doors are open, I mean, the first day after that, he said, well, we got to go to church. I said, I don't think you're going to be going to church in a while. Well, we got to go to church.